So I saw Rogue One and just wasn't that thrilled with the whole thing. Not that I don't like the idea and concept. I think that the idea of departing from the main story to tell what's happening in the background is actually a really cool idea to do in an established universe. But Rogue One was just okay. Its story didn't subtract from the old universe, but didn't particularly add to it. Its main characters weren't offensive, but they weren't interesting. It definitely has side characters, but we don't really connect with them. So I think that it's worthwhile dissecting what happened in this movie, and what we might need to make future installments in the planned Star Wars story franchise a little bit better. I mean, who knows, maybe a screenwriter working on that Boba Fett movie is watching this. Maybe. Well, here's my two cents anyway. My first impression of this movie is that it really wasn't very fun, and that's a problem. Star Wars, at least in the original trilogy, which everyone loves, is a space opera. Space operas are a swashbuckling breed of action, romance, and comedy that has fun and light as much as it does seriousness and darkness. Take Yoda. Before he takes up the serious role of our protagonist's mentor and spiritual guide, he takes the light-hearted role of a comic relief character. Similarly, Leia. During Han and Luke's rescue attempt, she has some great antagonistic banter with the bear, highlighting to the audience just how unprepared and short-sighted her rescue's plan is. This is funny, and therefore we empathise and laugh with her, see her as competent, undamsel-like, and just as importantly, so do the characters. This ebb into the light is important. It allows the moments where the story becomes dark to have much more impact. But Rogue One doesn't really have any of these moments. The story zooms from dark moment to the next without any room for these crucial silly moments that further or deepen the characters' ongoing emotional stories. Therefore, we never really get invested. I think that the lack of light in the movie doesn't exactly make the movie darker, per se, as many people have been saying. It just makes it absent of light, which leaves the film feeling, at the very least, quite hollow. My advice? Let's give Star Wars its comedic potential back. I don't mean just an ironic quip every now and again, it needs to be consistently funny and clever. Shots like these go miles towards making us invested in both character and the story. Speaking of which, our main characters. We have them, but we don't really know them. Sure, our main character Jin is described as this rebellious, roguish figure, but do we ever see her like this? We don't see her being sneaky much, or doing much rebellion until one crucial scene before the final act of the movie. So, we don't know if she enjoys being sneaky, if she's just doing it for survival, or fear, or as a factor of her legacy. Alright, maybe we know she's reluctant to join the rebellion, but why? We are never shown her alternative, or how she feels about it, so her stakes are less interesting, and sacrifice less meaningful. Our characters need to be fully understood. What are our characters coming from when they enter the movie? But also more importantly, how do they feel about it? Look at this shot of Luke in A New Hope. We understand in an instant, through music and cinematography, that he is feeling the call to adventure. His dreams of leaving the farm, and also his constraint. We gain here Luke's emotional history, in addition to his factual history of where he literally is, and what he literally does. In Rogue One, we get our factual history delivered fine, like in the Saw-Gerrera sequence, but there's no emotional reality. Saw and Jin exchange information, but no emotions, and the whole scene lacks the emotional history that should be evoked between our main character and her father figure. The result is that we aren't engaged with either character, and the story stops being a believable simulation. This leaning into factual rather than emotional history is going to be dangerous for the Star Wars story franchise. It will be easy to lean on the already established universe for emotional weight, but this will not be sufficient. Our main characters must experience the world through the camera as their own take on the Star Wars universe, not as a sideline to the main take. They must have believable emotional arcs fueled by their decisions and their history. Our side characters too were important, and shouldn't just be there to be quirky side characters. The Jedi monk dude is cool in concept, but his role was little more than to be quirky, then killed at the end. He offered nothing to our main character in the way of perspective, as C-3PO or Obi-Wan or Lando did. Side characters don't necessarily need arcs in the same way our mains do, but they do need to connect with our mains and offer them, or the story, something substantial. Lando, for example, represents the silent majority of the galaxy that is abused by the evil empire, but chooses to survive through cooperation. And we see that impact him emotionally. And similarly, we see why he changes to the other side emotionally. This could be a serious worry in the Boba Fett movie, which has great potential for a cool lead, but may have a universe populated with side characters that bore or are relatively unimportant to our main character in his story, as Boba Fett is a figure we've always viewed in isolation. No matter how singular movies seem to be in their plot, the best ones have sides that influence how we see our main characters. For example, Sergeant Powell in Die Hard or Alfred in Batman. Okay, while I could definitely go on, I'm going to restrain myself and throw things in a different light. This situation is far from hopeless. We have and are seeing the Star Wars universe do all of these things. Case in point, The Force Awakens. This movie was endlessly fun. It had jokes all the way through it, both visually and in some great dialogue, interspersing its dark moments. Our main characters are both fairly well designed and we understand them emotionally. Rey is confident, earnest, but also somewhat lonely and lost from her time on that planet that isn't Tatooine. Finn is nervous and comedically reluctant, but also quick-thinking, which makes sense given his history and escape from the First Order. Their emotional histories and decisions form together, and so we sympathise with them. Indeed, this applies even more so to the masterstroke of a villain that is Kylo Ren. We understand him perfectly throughout the movie, with the symbolic effect of the mask in particular speaking volumes about him. Our sides are also mostly good. BB-8 is cute and brings our main characters into the story and together, so fulfilling its requirements. Han Solo links the original trilogy to the current one, and allows us as well as our mains to get emotionally invested in this new trilogy as a follow-up to the old, so fulfilling his requirements. Look, I'm certainly not arguing that The Force Awakens was perfect, it absolutely wasn't. The Death Planet thread was unoriginal to the point of laziness, and the pilot Poe's character existed in this weird space between unimportant side character and main character. But the movie was certainly successful in revitalizing the Star Wars formula and feeling. This is important to get right in our spin-off movies, and the future trilogy to come. I wish them the best of luck. They got a hell of a task on their hands. See you next time.